the device by pressing the rotary knob. Turn the knob to select the PTC menu. Press the knob to enter the submenu. Turn the knob again and reselect the ATP mode. Press the knob for 2 seconds to enter the ATP menu. This graph illustrates the phases of neuromuscular block from the onset to the full recovery of the patient. What Tofscan modes can be used for? The aim of the ATP mode is to alternate the TOF and the PTC electrical stimuli to monitor a patient's level of neuromuscular block. The colored areas illustrate the different neuromuscular block depth levels. The ATP mode is specifically helpful during surgeries that require deep NMB. The autopilot ATP mode is a very simple and efficient way to monitor the patient's paralysis without having to change the mode manually. You can choose this mode at the beginning of the intervention and let it run until the patient has reached the recovery phase. The Tofscan pilots the choice of TOF or PTC according to the patient's response. A TOF will be applied every 30 seconds as long as the TOF count has one answer. When there are no more answers to the TOF count, then the PTC will automatically start. 4 minutes and 30 seconds later, a new TOF will be delivered. And if there are no responses, for example, a TOF count of zero, a PTC will start. This will continue until the TOF responses are back. Then the device will only do the TOF response every 30 seconds. Using the autopilot ATP mode will allow continuous safe block monitoring. It can be used any time from induction to recovery on paralyzed patients or not. Tofscan does not require calibration. The ATP mode pilots the choice of TOF or PTC stimuli according to the level of patient blockade. You can start the ATP mode at the beginning of the intervention or later. Once started, ATP requires no extra steps. Let the ATP mode guide you. It will help you to optimize your time in the operating theatre.